quality trumps growth. The simple formula on this is experience is greater than or equal to the price. Does that make sense? So my expectation is that it should be this level of experience, and if my experience is in reality equal to or greater than what I paid for it, then I'm happy. Straight up, guys, this business is growing, it's incredibly healthy, and we have thousands and thousands of happy customers, ecstatically happy customers. We look at the bad reviews and it really can get you down. And we got two choices, we can get mad or we can use the information to get better. We win as a team and we lose as a team. Every single person in this room is helping us get that five-star review or not and delivering that five-star service. It's not just the text, it's not just the CSRs. Every customer contact point needs to be dialed in and focused to deliver a really great experience. And when that's happening, that's when we win. That's when the customer wins, and that's when we get the five-star reviews. You can't fake this. You either care or you don't care. And even if you're pretending like you care, everybody can read your body language. In one of my recent trainings, I asked, who here is fluent in body language? Everybody's like, I don't know. Yeah, you are. You are. You just don't know you are. You've been learning it your whole life. We all observe and we watch and we see people's bodies, and they're telling us this entire story. Sometimes it matches up with their words. Sometimes it doesn't. But in our gut, we know something's off when we're talking to somebody and they keep turning away from us and kind of, you know, looking out the window, and they're like, okay, this person's not interested in being here right now. They're done. They're tired of hearing me yammer. Or whatever. All that is clearly speaking, you can't fake this. The technician side of professional craftsmanship, because when we think of craftsmen, we think of, you know, the old guy that looks like a wizard and weathered hands carving wood or whatever. But craftsmanship can be in anybody's role, whether you're a delivery driver or you're a CSR and how accurately you take the notes, finance department and their accuracy and efficiency, and all that conveys into a better product in the end because of what we're doing. So this is intended for everybody in the company to up their game and their professionalism in their specific role. How about you guys? I see a blend here of incredible talent, or me giving way too much time for that exercise. I'm not sure which. Building that rap was very resourceful. One of these things that conveys, guys, I mean, are you really trying for the customer? You guys have had that experience. I know you all have. You go in and you ask somebody for help and they're like, nah, can't help you. And you're like, I know if you got on the phone or just touched a couple keys on that keyboard, you could probably get me an answer. You know those people can help you. You hate those people, right? But again, this is that body language component of what I'm talking about, that if you're not being resourceful, it's known. You can't hide this crap. Use your words as best you can. They can see right through you and they know you're not delivering. I digress. We set the tone. We all do. We all bear a responsibility to set the tone. And it's like infectious if we're positive or negative. That just transfers from one human to the next. And it can go from the customer or to the technician in that. And technicians, stop beating up on the dispatchers and the CSRs. I mean, it does you no good. I mean, these people are fighting tooth and nail just like you are to make a difference and do what they do, and that goes both ways. So they're not your punching bag when you're frustrated either. The other lesson learned really profoundly in this last quarter specifically for me was really getting passionate about the customer experience again, falling in love with the customer. Technicians, warehouse, CSRs, dispatch, I mean, there's some balls in the air, and man, it's happening fast, and it's hard to keep track of. And so I get it, it's hard. But again, for us to be who we need to be, it's you've got to be open to opportunity to grow and change. You just do, and not take it personally. If we just shut all the ideas down for growth, then we kill possibility for change. It just is what it is, and I've just got to deal with it. And that's the result of that kind of thinking. So if we create an ideal, and we say this would be the best it could possibly be, then we can start working on ways to make it a reality.
I want to spin the wheel if people are excited about spinning. But
yeah, I'll spin it. Yeah.
Exceptional is our new standard. There's no okay isn't good enough anymore. It just isn't. For us to really be who Radiant's supposed to be in this marketplace, we are the industry leaders in Austin. We just are. I don't feel ashamed of it. Nobody is where we're at in our workmanship and in the way we handle each other and the way we do all of our day-to-day tasks. Exceptional has to be the new standard. So let's go out and let's kick some ass today and make this our new mantra. Sound good?